Good afternoon, everyone. As always, I apologize for my appearance. Welcome to another episode of Spilling Tea. I'm your host, Tiffany Daniels. We're going back to that horrible world known as the JRC. But before we do the usual disclaimers, if you are unfamiliar with the Stop the Shocks campaign or the campaign against the troubled teen industry, you're going to find all the pertinent links right there in the description box. Please, in particular, take note of the article written by NeuroClastic, a small non-for-profit started by autistics for autistics. In it, they interviewed over 800 ABA professionals regards to the JRC's so-called behavior modification program. The Judge Rotenberg Educational Center doesn't want you to read that article so much. They threatened NeuroClastic with a defamation lawsuit. They did not remove it from the website. NeuroClastic refused, so you know the drill. Please read the article. Share it on all your social media. Also included in there is NeuroClastic's public statement regards to the defamation lawsuit threat, as well as a link to their GoFundMe. We are crowdfunding just in case the JRC ever does see through with their threat. Trigger warning 1, when we discuss places like the Judge Rotenberg Educational Center or Agape Boarding School for Boys, you're going to hear vivid descriptions of and catch clips of surveillance footage of people with mental health issues and disabled people being tortured and abused. If you got young children present, please go ahead and use your headphones. Trigger warning 2, this channel is marked not for kids for a reason. We use profanity on occasion and speak on dark subjects. If your child's 16 and younger and they are watching this, very obviously parental supervision is advised, all right? Okay, now I'm pretty sure I managed in the last video because of the introduction to probably get myself another strike. And you know what? I don't care. Because medicine cannot evolve properly if it's not put up against relevant, logical, objective critique. Okay? We know now that autism, ADHD, and all the other similar neurodivergent disabilities are not behavioral disorders. So why are we still treating them through means of behavioral intervention? You say, but the behaviors come out though, and so that's why. Or, and hear me out on this, we could not use the ABA model, but still operate off the premise of getting to the root cause of the issue from where the behavior is stemming. I don't mean assume that you know what the underlying cause is and then treat that, because 9 times out of 10, you're going to be not just wrong, but like so wrong it physically hurts. Okay? I address these issues because they need to be addressed. Because there is literally 2 generations of autistics who've come up behind me having to go through the same crap, saying the same things we said, and still being shouted over. Okay? This may be a small platform, but I will use it. Anyways, back to the subject at hand, right? Also, I'm not going to apologize regards to what I said about the Olympics either. We need to, if we're going to get some semblance of sense, logic, and reason back in America, we need to start using it. I know some of you all, a lot of you all are out of practice, but please, dust it off. And let's start again, shall we? Because knee-jerking reacting to everything is exactly how we got in this mess in the first place. Now, let me go on. In contrast, as these comments pointed out, the use of ESDs does not teach a person new skills or replacement behaviors, does not mitigate the underlying cause, and cannot achieve behavioral conditioning for some patients who have conditions that impair their ability to understand consequences and react by changing their behaviors. Here we fucking go again. There is something that is prevalent within the medical model that is absolutely on its face so wrong that I don't properly have words to describe exactly how wrong it is. It is the idea that for our nonverbal autistics, people believe that they don't understand literally anything. They don't think that they understand forms of speech, people. They don't believe they understand what's going on around them, why they're being punished, reacting accordingly. Yeah. Right? The thing is, folks, that's not true at all. Not even remotely. We do have some issue. We do have some folks with comorbid diagnoses with another developmental disability. But even within that frame, everybody on an instinctual level has some understanding of consequences for actions. Even if it's on the most base level. Everybody understands that. Okay? Please stop with the nonsense here. Well, we can't. Like, they won't even talk. So how do we know that they can change their behaviors? I'll say it again. Start with a base of assuming you know nothing. And work from there. That's how we correct it. Any of your predisposed notions when it comes to working with us, even if you have to do it physically, write it down, throw it out the window, or set it on fire. Because more likely than not, it's inaccurate. There are nonverbals, not all, but there are some who are online, who do type. And they are still treated as though they don't understand. And they're still getting punished. Even if it's the more psychological ABA mindfuckery than it is the JRC's level of insanity. Just because they're not getting shocked doesn't mean it's not still the same idea behind it. Okay? Assume you know nothing. Full functional behavioral assessment. You can't be going around and skipping steps and expect it to work. All right? Yeah. Just saying. Even Dr. Blinkush of JRC stated that providers there can reduce the use of ESDs through skill training or other procedures that even people from JRC thought could not be faded off the ESDs responded to these treatments. You want to know the number one thing that I saw that turned behaviors completely around for people who share my diagnosis, nonverbal and otherwise? Providing a means, a way, a form where we are able to communicate. For some of us, that might mean sign language. For others, it might be having a little computer thing that we have that we're able to type on. For others, it might be an assistive device where we tap on the picture to say the word to indicate what it is we're trying to communicate. And you know what, folks? The reduction in the behaviors for the individuals who've had that as part of their treatment programs are reduced to a base level that resembles mine extremely closely. Okay? You can solve a whole lot of issues if you would stop trying to condition us to pretend being neurotypical and you instead utilize the technology that is out there right now and just some plain human creativity and ingenuity to help us be able to communicate so we can get to what's wrong. So we can get to the root cause. Okay? Don't just sit there and insist, but my child can't tell me what's wrong. They can't talk. Your child screaming? Yes, it never stops. Obviously, there's something wrong, but she can't tell me what's wrong. She's trying to, Karen. But you are so set in your ways that you want her to come all the way around to you instead of trying to communicate in a way that they may be able to understand. Okay? We used to have little expos at regional office. Started a year right before I came on to the team, as it were, where we would have companies that produce these assistive communicative devices and people who help teach sign language to the nonverbal and their parents so that everybody could come in and be exposed to the things that are available. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You can't continue to try to use behavioral means to treat things that are not behavioral disorders. You fell at get-go. You fell at get-go. Let's continue, shall we? These are some of the reasons that the field of ABA as a whole moved away from intrusive physical aversive conditioning techniques such as ESDs 2 decades ago. But they still have not let it go from the psychological mindfuckery. Ignore your child no matter how loud they scream in pain. That's a thing. So it can teach them to use their words. Remember when I said, if you stub your toe in the middle of the night, are you going to say very quietly, well, ow, I hit my foot on the table, that hurts? Or are you going to scream, ow, fuck? Why do you assume that we're so different? Yeah. A little more understanding. A little bit more meeting us in the middle. A little bit more understanding all this technology, assistive devices, and accommodations that we have at our fingertips. Instead of relying on a science that's to deal with behavioral disorders. Not neurodevelopmental ones. Not neurodevelopmental disabilities, okay? We're going to close on that, folks. We don't get very many views on this channel, and the few we do get do tend to get removed from time to time. You know the drill, folks. Please don't forget to hit the like button, hit subscribe. Don't forget to hit the comments. I appreciate your time. As always, folks, we here at Smelling Tea hope you have a good one. I'll see you again here in a few minutes. Bye-bye, everyone.